It is unclear how the final budget of the office of the vice president would look like after Vice President Sara Duterte again snubbed plenary debates. Several lawmakers are now accusing her of betrayal of public trust for skipping the deliberations. Vivian Guglia reports.
Boom. The House of Representatives' plenary deliberations on the proposed 2025 budget of the Office of the Vice President had to be moved from Monday to Tuesday after VP Sara Duterte did not show up and the representative from the OVP had no written authorization.
Since no one from the OVP has returned, considering the lateness of the hour, may I move, Mr. Speaker, that we include the OVP budget in the calendar of business of September 24, 2024.
On Tuesday, the House Committee on Appropriations called up the office of the Vice President, and according to panel Vice Chairperson, Representative Raul Angelo Bongalon, the OVP merely reiterated the contents of its September 11 letter to its House budget sponsor, which states that the OVP is leaving the plenary deliberations on its budget proposal entirely to the pleasure of the House of Representatives. Bongalon said the OVP did not mention it will send an authorized representative to the lower chamber.
This is a clear betrayal of public trust, as every elected official is accountable to the electorate and thus is obliged to answer any question that concerns public interest.
Technically po, it is in a way betrayal of public trust. But whether it would amount to impeachment, masyadong malayo naman po yun.
Bongalon issued this call.
Probably we can ask her to step down as the vice president. Kasi nakikita natin eh, hindi naman po siya dumadalo sa mga pandinig dito po sa Kongreso. So ano po ibig sabihin nito? Hindi na po siya interesado? So I guess it's the Filipino people. It's up to them, no, to judge the vice president.
In a statement, the office of the vice president tagged as an attempt to besmirch the reputation of the vice president stories that Duterte was supposedly on a beach while the OVP's proposed 2025 budget was scheduled for plenary deliberations at the House of Representatives on Monday. The OVP said Duterte made stops in Camarines Norte and Albay to talk to the people there. Lawmakers said they will extend maximum leniency to the vice president and wait for her or an authorized representative until Wednesday, when it targets to pass on final reading the proposed 2025 national budget. Asked about possible scenarios if no one from the OVP shows up until Wednesday, congressmen did not give a definite answer, but they said a reenacted budget for next year is unlikely.
I think the leniency afforded on this procedural issue will have its limit, and we will not sacrifice the budget for the sake of this, you know, procedural lapse. The substantive must reign, and still we will pass this budget. It's just that what we're trying to say here is that the budget will wait for no man. No? But in this case, it is a woman.
Kung ang tingin ng ating Vice President, eh kaya niyang isabotahe yung pagpasa ng budget ng ating pamahalaan for 2025, hindi po papayagan ng Kongreso yon.
The House of Representatives terminated on Tuesday the plenary debates on the proposed budget of the Office of the President and the Department of Education. Vivian Guglia, ABS-CBN News.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. certifies the proposed 6.35 trillion peso 2025 national budget bill as urgent. This would allow the House of Representatives to pass the General Appropriations Bill on second and third reading on the same day. Marcos says certifying the measure as urgent will ensure uninterrupted operation of critical government functions. House leaders are targeting to pass the budget today, September 25th. The Philippine Senate finally made Alice Go talk on what she knows about illegal pogos, but the former Bonbon mayor only disclosed who she said is the most guilty in an executive session with senators. Senator J.V. Ejercito says they were able to get something from it, even if the session only lasted for a couple of minutes. The closed-door session will be continued next week. Meanwhile, during the hearing, Go remained firm she is not behind illegal pogo operations.
Hindi pa ako mastermind. Masasabi ko po, isa pa akong victim.
Ikaw ay ginagamit ng isang criminal syndicate, international group o crime syndicate.
Your Honor, hindi naman po siya ginamit. If ever po, kung meron man po ako na itulong, ano po akong tao, helpful akong tao. Your Honor, I think sa tagal po na investigation, alam na rin po ng committee po, especially chaired by our Madam Chairman, who's really at the back of everything po.
Yang Jianxin, alias Tony Yang, the brother of former Duterte advisor Michael Yang, also took the hot seat during Tuesday's probe. Like Go, centers flagged irregularities in Yang's records after he admitted he is pure Chinese but was able to acquire Philippine documents. Yang also denied owning any business related to POGOs.
It was my grandfather who helped me come up with this birth certificate. Intention of my grandfather is for me to start a business here. That's why I use an English name so that I can also apply for business permits for other documentations that will be needed for the business.
Peke yung pagka-Pilipino ninyo, inaamin mo na nagpapanggap ka lamang na Pilipino para magkapera dito sa Pilipinas. You've been deceiving this country for the last 26 years.
Meanwhile, former Police Chief Benjamin Acorda also being dragged into the POGO mess. Photos of Acorda with Tony Yang and Wesley Go, Alice Go's brother, were flashed during the Senate hearing Tuesday. Senator Rizzo Ontiveros questions Acorda's possible links with the alleged POGO players.
I really wonder what our high officials in government are doing fraternizing with a wanted fugitive. At ito kaugnay nung statement na binasa kanina, it's not just about integrity, which is the most important thing, but also the perception of integrity na importante din.
Acorda, meanwhile, defends himself. He told ABS-CBN News he only loves his country and the Philippine police, and he only did what needs to be done as a Filipino and police officer. Acorda has been invited to the next hearing. Aside from Acorda, a photo of Yang with former President Rodrigo Duterte was also revealed Tuesday. But the businessman denies having close ties with the former president. Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Lori De La Cruz. Good morning, Lori.
Good morning, Medina, and all our viewers and listeners. At the moment, we're not monitoring any LPA or tropical cyclone inside the Philippine area of responsibility. The whole country will be experiencing partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of isolated rain showers or thunderstorms in the afternoon or evening. Easterlies is continuously the dominant weather system over the whole archipelago. Meanwhile, in the next 24 to 48 hours, there's a possibility that a low-pressure area will be developed or would be developed over the northern part or the northern portion of the area of responsibility, and it may affect the extreme north of Luzon, particularly Batates, Babuyan Island, some parts of mainland Cagayan, in the next few days. So we're advising the general public to continue monitoring on the progress or the development of the possible weather system in the coming days. That's the latest from PAGASA. This is Lori De La Cruz.
Thank you very much for that update, Lori.